Safaris. Why do I name this stuff silly stuff like this? I don't say podcast.
It sounds scary. Let's go on safari. I try to make it fun so teachers won't be scared. And I give them time to giggle. Just a little. I send them on three missions. Go find a funny video, I say. Women laugh at different things than men. Women laugh at funny pets and funny babies. Men laugh when a guy cuts down a tree that lands on his truck. Right? So I give them time to just go laugh a little bit. Then I say, all right, I want you to go out and find a video that's personally rewarding to you. And they do that. Then I say, now go find a video that would be good for your students. And then I do that. Three missions into the jungle. And they go, Now bring them all back into the clearing and put them in the supply hut for all of us. So one school I work with, Hayesville Charter School in Wichita, Kansas, headphones on, and they're taking YouTube piano lessons. Not from YouTube, the site. We pulled them off using a site called Zamzar, ZAMZAR.com. You put in the URL, tell it what file type you want. They send you an email link to where you can download the content so you're not sending them out there. And those girls are taking piano. Is it as good as a real teacher? Absolutely not. Is it better than the nothing they had before? Absolutely. So there are crazy things out there that we're talking about. Here's what I'm telling kids. Guys, what is their digital footprint? If I Google you, will you be proud of what I find? Are you in control of what I find? This is the new resume. This is the lifelong resume. See, our puberty isn't on the record. Hopefully. Right? You ever do anything stupid? Is it on the record? Our kids are growing up and they're telling everything. Right? That can be a good thing. That can be a bad thing. Your daughter can get the scholarship because of what she said online, or lose it. Are we even talking about it? Are we talking about, are they proud of the things they're posting? So your daughter wants a job at my industry, and I go back, in eighth grade she was volunteering in the community. I like that. I'm hiring her. That's a good story. Or I can see your 16-year-old son's party puke pictures and not hire him because I'm worried, you know? So I think we've got to start talking to kids about what this looks like, this lifelong resume. I think it starts in elementary school. I think they're publishing to an authentic audience, but not with their name, with a digital pen name. They publish. When they turn 18, they take possession of all the stuff they build. Right? Turn the key and poof, that's my life. But not when they're little. There's a way we can do this. Right now they're doing it anyway. They're doing it anyway. They're peeing in the pool. We can help, but we got to understand the world just a little bit. Here's what I think. In every district, you guys need a Magnificent Seven, a team of go-getters, and don't make it all young faces. Do not make it all young faces. Okay? You got people who've been there from the beginning. Their faces and their gray hair will win the rest of the faculty. If you only have the young faces, they're going to go, of course they can. They've been doing it ever since they were born. You got to have the veterans, the Yodas. On faculty, right? And you send them out there and say, go find the best of free stuff and bring it to us once you've found out how to tame it, how to tame the tool in the sandbox over here. Not with kids, not with teachers. And they'll bring that to faculty meetings and that'll be best practices. Here's how we can use YouTube, and only under these circumstances. We've written a policy exception for these things. There's a way you can do innovation, but if all we do is firewall, absolutely will not happen. Here's what worries me. COPPA, SEPA, we have to firewall. I get it. There's padding on the edges of everything. Kids can never bump their head until they go home. Well, there's no firewall, and they absolutely get in trouble. There's got to be a middle ground somewhere. We've got to talk to parents, too. The firewall they want to get is the one between their kids' ears, and that one takes work. There's no lazy person's way to raise kids these days. They got to get involved in their kids' lives. How many of you use Lulu? This was invented, it changed the world, a lot of people don't even know it. LULU.com, self-publishing for free. Okay, in the old days, if you want to be an author, you could go to a vanity press. If you don't have an agent or talent, a vanity press will charge you money to publish your book. They won't edit. You can publish any book you want, they'll publish it, right? You're not a real author and it costs money. You buy 100, you sell 50, you eat 50. That's kind of how that works, right? Lulu comes along. I can publish a book, cost me nothing. Okay, as soon as someone orders it, they make it and ship it, they get their cut and you get your cut. Okay, you set the margin. You have a storefront where you can sell these books, right? So think as administrators, what materials are you paying to have made now that you can outsource to this for no money and actually generate revenue? I'm thinking athletic calendars would be a hot item. They do calendars, right? How about something as crazy as a yearbook? Life Touch come to your school? Take money out of there. I know schools are doing their whole yearbook on Lulu themselves. Uploading a PDF of the whole yearbook and they make the money. That comes to their PayPal account.
Why not try that? Give one of your Magnificent Seven this job. First, let her make a cookbook with 10 pages. And she's going to go, that was easy. Now let's try it for school. So if you're inviting your teachers to try this, have them do a personal thing. Your son's soccer season. They'll love it. They won't realize you're sneaking in the window. And the next time you talk, you go, okay, now how might we let kids be famous? I want you thinking in your mind, what are some ways we could leverage this? This changed the world, but only if you think so. And here's what I know. I talk to teachers all over the country. But when I talk to leaders, big stuff happens fast. Because if you guys say, nope, we're doing this, it suddenly happens. I've learned a big lesson here. That inspired leadership is the key. For you guys understanding some of these things. Giving kids a shot. Okay, Mandy, my girl who wrote the book Saving Me had never had